He comes in. My man comes in on boom, boom, boom. Yeah. Go ahead, crank that shit just up. Just crank it, and I'll come in a second. Keith Moon drumming on that. I forgot the nerd that did all the synth shit. That was like early synth. Like all that synth shit that we like, that was like early synth. Where they literally had a giant wall with like different plugs. That they would plug one thing into the other thing and then be like, okay, that's sweet. Then I'll plug another thing into another thing and another thing into another thing. It didn't even look like a musical device. But these musicians learned how to play that. And there's a lot of Who songs where they can't play them like, they can't like, you know, like you play some shit live and you go off and you like freestyle and you're like fucking dorking out and shit. That you can't do that on there because they have this little programmed in. Fucking Teenage Wasteland, Baba O'Reilly. What up, though? I know you're like, great, Jude. Yeah, more useless information I can use at a bar. When I'm talking to some 55-year-old lady trying to fuck her, I can tell her about Keith Moon and synthesizers and in his loose drum playing style that complimented it. And I will say, you are welcome, sir. I'm chock full of useless information. And there's more where that came from. I think I was having sex with this. I haven't slept with her again, but it's not because I wasn't into her or anything. It's just shit came up. I got sick. Da 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 da. Boom. Da da boom. And then you just never end up like the shit just doesn't connect again. But like, man, I'd be like mid stroke or we'd be done, and I just and a song would be out, and I'd wanted to tell her the 20 fucking useless facts about that goddamn song. God, I know it's got to be annoying. I actually like The Who, but I'm not a huge fan of them. I don't really like. It's like the shit I like, I really dig, but I couldn't be like, go get this album. I don't know if it was Roger Daltrey or Pete Townsend that was doing all the little fucking nerdy shit, but boy, they was on that synth shit early, bro. On YouTube, there's a synth. Type in BBC synth documentary. Look, you ain't got shit to do today. Type in BBC synth documentary. I think I end up doing like a whole fucking pill mix based on that shit, just because I was like so inspired by that fucking synth doc. Like so much shit came from the use of synth. It's amazing. It is amazing when you get people that know how to play and then you give them new technology and you're like, go ahead and play with it. And now what we have is people that can't play for shit and then we have new technology. It's like, don't worry, we'll cover for you being a complete piece of shit. Yeah, listen to this shit. Shit comes in hard. When I was doing the balloons to beat Wuhan, this is one of the songs that anything that would go like high pitched, That was my jam, man. That was my fucking jam. So that won't get fooled again. Won't get fooled again. It's all about how we get fooled again. It's all about how we vote and we get the same shit over and over, and it's just dressed differently, and we think that we're like fucking smart, but we're not. We're just idiots. And it ends. Meet the new boss, same as the old boss. Shoot yourself in the head, bitch. Shoot yourself in the head, bitch. I don't know if that's like the base message of the song. That was one of the things I got from it. Art's like that. You get what you need out of it, or get what you can understand out of it. You'd be amazed. I write these two books and I like fucking pour my fucking heart and soul on the page. And I'm like, oh, I like the songs. Oh, you write stories about fucking. Like, that's all you got out of that? Okay, fine. Thank you for writing the review. I appreciate you. You fucking idiot. But I do appreciate you for writing the review, because it does take time. Hyena and Hummingbird, two other things I couldn't go on fucking. You can listen to them for free on YouTube. If you like them, buy them as gifts for people. They're great gifts, great stocking stuffers. Hummingbird and Hyena. Let's go. I think that's what I was gonna say. That was about it. What, we got Kanisha Bus on the net today. Kanisha will be calling in. You know, as we are all quarantined in separate places. And, like, you guys don't even know the amount of shit that we got to go through just to get people on. If you do want to get on the show, text 213-205-3747. And we'll get you on the show. Also, I don't think I sent out the pill mix from last week. If you want any pill mixes or just any mixes that I do, whether it be like the Coke on the Boat series, Stepdads in Rehab, it's a favorite. Pills, Beers, and Child Support. Lifeboats and Strippers is just my life right now. Among the other ones, I was very inspired by the Yacht Rock shit and just decided I would just turn it up and broaden it up. If you want any of those, you can text 213-205-3747. We'll talk to Kanisha, catch up with her. We can see how quarantine and the baby life is treating her. See if she's getting any more milk. Kanisha got them big ass titties and got a milk problem. Ain't that a bitch?
Does seem weird.
You never know, man. Hey, look at the Asian, look at the Chinese motherfuckers. Look at them. Look at them. Look at their little dicks. Look at their dicks.
Every day.
Every day you look at their dicks, right?
That's not true.
Every day. You already said it. Too late. And who's there the most of? Them. Don't let the size of some shit fucking get you down. It's how you use that shit and how often you use that shit. So you might not have a bat, but you can fucking get it going, bro. You still have fucking 8 kids. Blah 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 blah. Where you splat? Where you splat? I was thinking about that. I think what, like, Everything's getting, everything gets, if you fucking have corona and get, have a meteorite land on you, you die of corona. So I think they're doing like, we're trying to like fuck the curve up and like straighten out the curve and just like end up losing like what, 2,500 people a day or some shit for I don't know how long. That's going to be a while. You know what I'm saying? Get 100 days of that, that's 250,000 people. That's a fucking lot.
Oh, yeah.
Just wrap your mind around it and just be okay with it, okay? They're doing the best they can, and the best they can is we're going to lose 250,000 people. That being said, those numbers are highly inflated for everyone's own personal reasons. Whether you're in fucking, I don't know, you're a doctor or you're in government or anything like that. So as you're freaking out, just look at the big numbers and just divide them bitches and be like, eh, all right, shit happens. Once again, Judy, just trying to calm you down. Calm you down. New way of looking at things. Maybe a different little way of looking at things. How can that be though? Like,
what?
Like you smoke? How long you been smoking cigarettes for?
Oh, too long. I mean,
like, all right, let's say you've been smoking for however long, 20 years, and you're smoking a pack a day.
No, I mean there were times where I do that. Probably these days, 10 and below.
10. All right, so you're down to half a pack a day at the most. You were doing what?
Oh, a pack, something like that.
Pack, probably a little bit more, let's just say.
Mm-hmm. Depending on the night, and, sure.
And yep, depending on the night, and then you're drinking a lot.
Right. Derelict.
So your body is just a fucking wasteland.
Just hanging on.
Yeah, your body's barely hanging on. So let's say you go to the hospital and get like some shit because all your smoking and drinking finally caught up with you. And while there, you get the virus, but then your liver gives out. Guess what they're going to blame it on? The virus.
It certainly won't help.
No, that's exactly what they're going to blame it on. So just don't believe everything you read. Okay, guys? Question everything. Even question me. Question this dumbass. Hey, it took you 5 years to graduate high school. What the fuck are you doing talking about this shit, you fucking moron? I'm sticking with Fox and CNBC, dude. Suck my dick.
Fox. Boo.
Oh, my God.
Sorry.
I'm just saying. No, like, hey, look, you're not the only one that doesn't like Fox, but the fact that you guys differentiate some shits by now. I just try to look for the truth. Just try to look for the truth. That's all I'm trying to do. I don't even want to get into this, but I can murder you. Like, I'll murder you right now. Like, it's just like...
No, for what?
I'll tell you off the air. The shit that I like, shit that I peep, and then shit that I peep.
What did I do?
I'm not saying you. I just like the truth. I'm not this guy. I'm not red. I'm not blue. I'm not purple.
I'm not
none of that shit. I just like truth. So someone's spitting facts. I'm like, okay, spitting. All right, they saying some facts, and then other shit. I'm like, okay, they on some bullshit.
I thought you were going to tell me some lady I was talking to sent you a dick pic of mine or something. I was like, what? What did you get? All right, never mind.
Why would I? That's how paranoid you are.
I just got sidetracked in my head.
I don't give a fuck about that. I just want people to be like, yo, man, just because it comes from a certain place. Look into it. Double check it. Triple check it. And if it's right, it's right. And if it's wrong, it's wrong. That's it. And check different, and check different fucking, check different shits. That's it. That's it. Think for yourself, guys. Got Kanisha Bus coming up. I was talking to John off the air, and I'm like, man, it's, you know, it's, we've been lucky enough to have this and that and this and that. We've got some backup fucking, we got some backup, what's it called?
Interviews. Questions in the can. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. But, I think we're going to be doing two. We're going to be doing two What Would You Do's a week now. I think one on Monday, which will be good. Because cats just, you know. Usually you're coming off the weekend, you did something stupid, so I'll help you with that. And then we got Wednesday, midweek, and then we'll fill it all. We'll fill everything else in. Get you your free shit, everything. Kanisha Bus is coming up next. Do not go anywhere. After that, it is the news. Let's get it.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
Shade 45. We got everybody's favorite, Kanisha Bus, longtime regular. Hey, Kanisha.
Hey, what's going on, man?
Shit, I'm over here on the couch. You out there running errands. How you doing?
Man, living in the rapture, apparently. I've been reading the Bible. I feel like it's the end of the Bible. I'm trying to figure out if I'm going to make it or not. I'm nervous.
Based on what you've been doing? Oh, you fucked.
I know. I'm like, wait, if the Lord come back today, I don't know if I'm going to make it. I need some, during this quarantine, you know, I'm trying to do some charitable giving. But no, I don't have nothing to give.
No, they're going to hear about you, them young bucks and them PS3s, and they're going to be like, oh, I don't know. She's been a good mom so far, but that ain't going to undo it. That ain't going to undo it.
I know. I'm regretting every time I was online and I seen something foolish. And I was like, you know what, God, just come back now because we don't deserve to be here. Like, I don't mean that. Like, now I take it back.
I know. Or I'm just like, man, hurry the fuck up with your shit. Like, hurry up and just hit us with a meteor. Killing me fucking slowly as hell. I'm like eating a can of beans every now and again. You know what I mean? I'm like, I got all this like quarantine stash that's not even getting used. So I'm like, oh, I guess I'll have a can of pork and beans. I don't know what the fuck I was. Did you buy anything for quarantine?
First of all, I went to 32 stores in 3 days. There was no tissue anywhere. And the only reason I got some tissue, my homegirl was at Slop and Swap Me, because you know you could go to the hood and still get supplies. So she brought me up some tissue.
That's smart. I was,
and
the
then
crazy shit.
I spent hella money on groceries.
What'd you get?
Man, like, so we did a lot of frozen, and I like, because you know, I'm vegan, so vegetables go bad every 3 or 4 days. So now I'm trying to Ziploc veggies in the fridge and do all type of stuff. And I'm just like, this is so stressful, yo. It's so stressful. And then we could still go back to the store. In my mind, everything was closing. It was about to be the purge. I mean, you should have seen the shit I came up with. I was ready. I got a gas mask in here.
Don't even know how that bitch worked. Just got a gas mask.
I just realized I don't even have the filter on it. I was like, oh, I didn't even buy the filter. I just got the gas mask. So the bottom part is open. I was like, bitch, you did.
Hell no. I know.
Oh my goodness.
That's most of us, man. We just out here like don't know what the fuck we're doing, just doing whatever the fuck they tell us to do. I was actually outside talking to my homeboy in the front yard, like, you know, in the front part, like right next to my crib, and y'all, neither one of us had a fucking mask on, bro. You should have saw the looks. It was like we was out there fucking just mutilating baby goats or some shit like that. They was looking at us like crazy. Like, what the fuck? Why are they staring at us like that? And I was like, oh, it was a fucking, the mask. Mm-hmm. Like.
Oh, yeah, if you don't got the mask on, it's a problem.
Oh, yeah, people got real. Yeah, clearly, there was. But, you know, I'm in Silver Lake, so wasn't nobody going to say shit. But still, it was just like, yeah, they was just like, nah, bro. Looking at me crazy, motherfucker. I couldn't figure it out. I thought that was for, like, the mask to go. Like, I understand. Like, you put on a mask if you need to go inside of somewhere. But, like, I'm out front of my crib, dog. I'm just over here chilling. Like, nah. Nah.
Nope, they don't care. They want you to have a mask on at all time. And the sad part is I got two of these little crazy mask things. And then I was like, well, one's for me and one's for the baby. So some shit go down. I don't know what's about to happen to you. That's all there was two. I don't have time to be in a crisis with a baby. And then people like, right. I still have to take her on a walk. Like, she's just in the house. You got to take her on a walk. And then people are like, a few people are like, how come you don't have a mask on the baby, just a regular mask? I was like, babies take masks off. I mean, she's not going to sit there and suffocate in the damn mask. She takes it off. So don't be worried about my mother. And let me keep going before I kill her father. We got to get out the house.
Straight the fuck up. And you're like, you know, like, it's mostly for fucking old people and fucking hypertension motherfuckers, man. Like, but, you know, what the fuck do I know? I'm not an expert here.
Apparently, ain't nobody a damn expert. Every time I turn around, it's a new development. And let me tell you something. When they said you'll lose the sense of taste, this is a true story. The minute they said that you would lose the sense of taste, and you know I haven't had no meat in like almost 2.5 years. Do you know I got some fish and chips? Because I was like, the last thing I'm going to do is die a vegan. Y'all got me fucked up. The minute I heard that, I was like, let me go taste these fish and chips one last time, just in case I get this shit. I'm not dying. No vegan, y'all. It's not about to happen.
Yo, and that's a really good test. Like, if you feel your shit start slipping, be like, all right, man, let me go get a steak or some shit just to make sure I can fucking make sure my taste buds working. Like, all right, good. I'm fucking...
Hell yeah. I was like, no, this ain't it. This, I can't go out like this. So let me get on out of here. Went to the grocery store, you know.
I was talking about how you're not titty feeding that much. How's the milk going? You doing the massages and shit like that?
I'm still doing the massaging, the heating. It's a little bit, like, I'm literally, she's getting 1 8-ounce bottle a day. And most people would have given up by now, but I'm just trying to give her as much milk as possible, especially with this pandemic going on. I'm like, okay, this is the best medicine I could give her. Mm-hmm. But when I tell you I'm over it, I am over it. I haven't stopped because it's only a few little drops at a time coming out. And then she, when I'm asleep, she'll lift my shirt up or move whatever's out the way and start squeezing my nipples and spurting herself in the face. I'm like, we can't be wasting no milk, yo. She thinks it's so funny.
You're like, yo, you better lick that shit up, man. What the fuck's wrong with you?
Don't be out here wasting food. Put your mouth on it.
Straight up. How you and your old man doing? You guys going crazy in a house together, or what's that like?
Relationships are, you're not supposed to see the person every day all day. That, there's no relationship in the world is about to survive this. It's fun for the first week, maybe even the first week and a half. But then little stuff, the way he cleans his ears gets on my nerves. I mean, anything he does, it drives me crazy. So we're either fighting or having sex or watching Ozark. Those are the three things. Like, I ran away from home last week. I sat in my car for 9 hours because there's nowhere to go. Usually I would go to a bar, whatever. I was like, I am really just sitting in the car, not doing anything. But I want to make him believe I'm out here with the COVID. I'd rather catch COVID than being here with you. That was the effect I was going for.
You out there IG live and that shit for fucking 9 hours. I mean, especially out here, like, we're in the big city, so, like, you know, one bedroom apartment for three people isn't the craziest shit ever. So, like, you're really on top of one another out here.
Let me tell you, on top, and it's annoying. Like, we got into it, and I threatened to break the TV. And so we're standing there. He's telling me to do it, and I'm sitting there going, you don't know me. I will do it. You don't know me all the way yet. But in the back of my mind, because I'm more mature now, because 2 years ago, I would have broke it. But in my mind, I'm going, listen, this is the front room TV, and we are on lockdown. If I break this TV, I am going to regret it. But I'm still sitting there acting like I'm going to break it, you know, just to show them I would. But we are on lockdown, so lockdown saved the TV. I will say that. I was like, I can't be in this house without no TV.
And you know what? You also got to give it to him for giving you enough credit to being like, she ain't. You know, she's grown as a person for me to fucking speak to her like this.
Mm-hmm.
If she if she was a fucking lunatic, I'd be much nicer. But like, yo, all right, she's chilled out a bit, so I can be like, yeah, go ahead, do that shit. I wish you would break this bitch. I'll be on my motherfucking iPad, bitch.
And it's funny, especially because people from back east, they always love to say where they're from when some shit is going down. I don't know why people do that. It's just so funny. Right. He like, I'm from Baltimore. You think I care? You think I ain't seen people turn up? I'm from Baltimore. I'm from Seattle. And crazy white people break shit. And I got crazy white mom, and they break anything. All right? Right up. We'll tear this whole house up. White people crazy. Yep. It's crazy.
Everybody's got no one's got the corner locked on breaking shit in your home, but you know what I mean? In a fucking argument, I've seen every race do that shit. I've seen motherfucking Cubans stab televisions with goddamn screwdrivers. I've seen motherfuckers throw shit, like white, black, other, everyone throw shit, dog. It's just what we do. It's the way we say I love you.
I know, huh? Because don't nobody got the corner on crazy. Everybody is crazy everywhere, especially with this damn COVID-19. I know people, kids is getting their ass whooped. That's what I really feel bad for, is kids somewhere getting their ass whooped for not doing nothing. I have put on Facebook, don't be over there beating them kids. They don't want to be home with your funky ass either.
I know.
I feel so bad for people with kids.
Well, I think, you know what? I really think, hopefully it's not gonna, but I really think, I hope it makes mothers and fathers reevaluate how they treat their kids, because they treat their kids like these little babies instead of like parts of the family that fucking add on to the goddamn family. You know what I mean? Like, oh, you had a kid? That just means like, oh, I had a brand new dishwasher. You know what I mean? Like, you just had... You had a dishwasher and a vacuum cleaner. You know what I mean? Like, that's how it was back in the day. I don't know what the fuck it is. And then on the farm, you're like, oh, yeah, he milks cows. I had a cow milker. Like, it's not like no more. Kids be sitting up while you be doing all the fucking work. And then the parents got the nerve to complain about their fucking kids. It's like, nah, man, you got to fucking teach your kid how to be a fucking adult. I got to deal with them. So hopefully, maybe, like, this will get people to start treating their kids, giving them some responsibilities. It's a pain in the ass. And they do a shitty job at first, but like, you know, like, shit be fucked up, man. I remember me first doing them dishes, man. Them shits look like shit. But like, you learn over the years, you learn how to do good dishes. Yo,
let me tell you something. Dishes used to make my hands. I still have a phobia of soap and water to this day. That's why my freaking showers be so quick. Soap and water together drives me crazy. So I didn't have to do the dishes growing up, so my sister did, and I would just stand over her and sing Cinderella. So I never had to do dishes growing up, just because I have a real life phobia of soap and water. It's the weirdest. It mixed together and drives me bananas. I don't know what the fuck it is, but it does.
What'd you have to do instead of the dishes?
I had to sweep the kitchen, sweep and mop.
Yep, sweep and mop. I know. Yeah. That's sweep and mop every fucking day. Every day we'd have to sweep the goddamn house. Lucky for us, it was a one bedroom, but still. But like, yo, you know, just every day sweep and mop, shit like that. Shit like that.
I know. My mom used to make her wash the walls and shit. I don't even think kids are cleaning up like that no more, where you have to wash the walls clean up all day.
No, none of that. Yeah, ain't no wall washing. My grandma had my mom like ironing sheets at 4. You know what I mean? She's like, you can hold an iron. Iron these motherfucking sheets and fold them. And my mom's 5 foot right now. Like, imagine a 4-year-old version of her ass, like, out there with a fucking iron, ironing sheets. But yo, like, You see it all over the world. Kids doing, like, actually kids actually helping out and shit. I see it in Westerns, man. They'll be like, I'm going to get your maw. She got took by the Indians. I'm going to leave you here with your sister. There's the cow. Here's a rifle. Don't kill a chicken if you're sick. I'll be back in 2 months. I'll be like, all right, pa. Like, damn, dog. That's some hard-ass shit.
That is true, Kay. The responsibility is so different. These kids don't be responsible for nothing. Just don't lose your phone and your house key. That just be it. They don't be responsible for nothing, yo. That's why they can't do shit.
Not a fucking thing.
They can't
thing.
Do anything.
Let's talk about sex. It said you said that you and your man are having like decent sex and stuff like that, because we're gonna talk about it in the news, and I'd love to hear your take on it. All right,
remember the last time? Go ahead.
Go ahead. Keep going.
The last time I came in there, remember I told you they had sewed my vagina up so tight. I mean, it felt like I was having sex with knives. I am still halfway miserable. It's been a whole year, and I have to use, the baby broke me, and I didn't think this was going to happen. I have to use lube and all type of stuff that I never had to use before, and it's still painful, but it gets better after initial pain. But I mean, we have actually been having a lot more sex than normal, obviously, because we're at home a lot, and we drink every day. And I have some wine 10 minutes ago. It doesn't even make no sense. We have no sense of time. So we've been having sex. I took 2 Plan Bs in the last, I think, 2.5 weeks, yo. I'm like, yo, I can't keep taking these Plan Bs because, one, they're not 100% accurate because of the baby.
Uh-uh.
2, they rose the price on Plan B.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. And how much they cost now? Before, they was like 50 or 60 bucks. What are they now?
Yeah, and they had got all the way down to $45. I was like, yo, Plan B, $45 now. Them must be $72.
Get the fuck out of here.
We got them for $72. I was like, yo, we spent $150 on Plan B, yo? Well, he did. If women buy their own Plan B, that's some bullshit. You better tell them to cash app you. I don't care if it was a one-night stand and you're not even going to take it. Get your Plan B money.
Dude. And as a man, I'm like, be a gentleman. Bottom of I'll pay for, if the girl wants to go half and on abortion, yeah, sure, whatever. Like, I'm definitely, like, I'll pay for the full abortion. I'll pay for the fucking full Plan B. I do not give a fuck. I will be a gentleman, because the other way is I got 18 years of child support and I got to fight with you to see the fucking kids. So, like, I don't even want to have to deal with that shit, man. Like, nah. Not even close.
You don't. And it's funny, especially him, for somebody who keeps saying he don't want no more kids, men always act surprised, like they don't know how you got pregnant. That's what be wearing me out. They just always act surprised, like, I just don't know how this happened. Like, yo, I can't get myself pregnant. You have to be responsible for your seed, yo. So if
is
you
he
don't
nutting
be
up in you?
Huh?
What, is he nutting up?
That's stupid, right? And we weren't using condoms. We have went back to using condoms. But I hate condoms. I'm already dried because of the baby. I don't know what happened to my flow system. It's jacked up.
Right.
So condoms already, you know, it's be smelling like burnt rubber. It'd be itchy. Like, nobody want to deal with that. And most people get in relationships just to smash raw, not even for love. Just be like, you know what? I can have consistent, unprotected sex. So I'm going to just go ahead and roll with you. Like, that's what it's for, especially when you have a baby already. So...
Then it's
just like, what are you going to do? And when you're drinking, condoms is the last thing on your mind. We're not even in our right mind. And we're bored. We're crazy. It's just like, let's have sex.
Well, I'm glad that you're able to slowly get into the sex thing and just like, your pussy's snapping back. And like, I bet you within the next, by next year, you're going to be like straight again, I think. Yeah, I think it's going to take you another full year. I do. I think you get this.
Because the pain that I still have.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
The pain that
I was saying you're right, because I still have the same pain. I still have pain. Like, I can't believe it's still painful a year later. You know what I'm saying? Like, come on. So we, you know, I think we've had more sex during this quarantine than we have in a whole year.
Hmm.
I know. That's so sad.
Well, no, it's sad and it's not sad. Yo, here. Yeah. So they came over with this. I was watching this shit on Shark Tank the other day. I've been binge watching Shark. You know, you binge watch shit, and I love me some Shark Tank because I always feel like, I got a really good idea. That's, and I then you think you understand business. Well, if I, you know, for $100,000 and they get 10% of the company, my company's worth $1 million, even though I ain't got shit over. I'm so fucking thing. That's in my brain. But they got this shit basically where it's two buttons on either side of the bed. And if you're kind of in the mood, you're not all the way in the mood to do it, and you don't feel like getting shot down, you can just boop, hit the button. And if the other person doesn't hit the button, it doesn't, like, it just, it's like it never happened. If you both hit the button, it's like boop 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 boop, and then y'all can have like a quickie or whatever the fuck. What do you think about that? And do you think that's a good or bad idea? Yeah,
I think that is a fabulous idea, and I want it immediately. I love that idea. I love it. I could see my dude dismantling and restructuring my button and then jumping on me and be like, you pushed the button. You pushed the button.
It's green. It's blinking green like a motherfucker. Yep.
Be like, come on, man. I'm already excited now that it's beacon, so go ahead and give it to me.
Yeah, it's like, straight the fuck up. It's, that's kind of, I thought that was interesting, too, because, like, I haven't been in a long-term relationship in a long time. And I've been, you know, I'm an open motherfucker. So I just be like, look, man, I'd love to fuck, but I got 10 minutes in me. You know what I mean? Like, or you know what I mean? Like, I got
10 is perfect for me. I don't like over 10. 10 is perfect.
You would fucking hate fucking me. You'd be like, really? Like, really, motherfucker? I did acid with my ex a few weeks ago. And there was some shit where, like, we was in different generations. Like, we was all over the fucking, you know what I mean? We went through, we would just stop and just be dripping wet and be like, what the fuck did we just, where we been at? Like, fucking the tape flip, the whole damn nine. Be like, whoa, dog. So, like, I understand why a woman would just want 10 minutes. So
it'd be too much, especially this, you know what I'm saying? I mean, every now and then, but back in the day, I used to be able to do that for hours and hours, but now I'm like, I gotta get to the point, especially because my vagina hurts really now. I'd be like, oh, I hope it could be a couple minutes and I'd be over there doing the most. You know, because you can say stuff to trigger dudes to finish early, so I'd be saying all that, anything I can say.
I've gotten wise to some of the girls too, though. I'm like, I know what you're trying to do. And then it turns me off. I'm like, yeah, you're not slick.
Oh yeah, come on. Oh, just a little bit hard. Oh,
I'm like, bitch, you fucking lie. For that, it'll fucking be longer. Goddamn lie.
I'm telling you, that's but it'd be working. It'd be like, I gotta get up. Not even up. I just want to get away. I just want to lay back down. Because dudes hate hearing you're tired. I don't know what triggers y'all to get so upset when we're tired. But y'all really do not like us to say that. Like, yo, I'm tired. Oh, you can just lay there. Just lay there.
I know.
Like,
it's the worst.
I don't have time for this.
I know. It's the worst. The worst is when they're jacking you, when I go to the rub and tugs, and then they do the moan shit to your ear. It's like, come on. You're looking dead at the lady, like, lady. Nothing. Like, I'm not doing anything, anywhere. I'm not touching any erogenous zone on your body, and you're like, oh, so good. Oh, you come for me now. You come for me now. Oh. I'm just like, bitch, all right, man. I'm gonna be quiet. Let me just not concentrate on you patronizing me while you fucking jerk me off.
I love this shit, yo. Sex is so crazy. And I'm really still, I'm listening to that, and I'm still thinking about this idea with the bed. Like, I need you to put this in full force. Like, I'm over here going, damn, I really want that button. Because then you don't got to do all that faking and arguing and all that. I can just push my button and go back to sleep. I need you to do something with this.
I thought it was a great idea, and the worst part was, like, man, they fucking murdered them and kicked them out the goddamn thing. It's like, Jesus Christ. Yeah, you know, bro. You go in there like with one leg and cancer, man. They'll sign you for anything and shit. But if you just like regular with a bad pitch, they'll fucking kick your ass out on your ear, no matter how good your fucking idea is. Like, yeah.
Well, I need to start watching it. I gotta. I'm up to go in the house and watch it. Everybody, I'm like, what are people watching? What's next? Shit. Because it's, you start watching stuff, like you said, it get in your head. I've been watching Ozark, and for some reason, I be thinking the feds are after me. I'm like, I ain't even doing shit. What am I? Like, you just be nervous. Just being proactive about nothing.
I know.
Like, why? Do you think?
I know.
I'm like, man, maybe I could. I'm trying to launder money. No money to launder anything. It's like, what the fuck is going on?
Man, I don't know. Everybody's all paranoid. I'm like, yo, by the time with all this legal wiretapping shit they got going on, bro, like, when it's time, they'll come get your ass. Like, ain't shit you can do. You can say all the fucking little fake words and all that shit. Go run through mm-hmm. 8 different burners a fucking day. Like, they know your ass, man. Get the fuck out of here. I mean, hey, maybe they don't.
Every cold word it is out there. Do you hear me? They're like, hear these. I bet you they be like, listen to these dummies still talking in code. This shit is from the 90s. The fuck y'all talking
I know.
About?
This, I know. Someone sent me like a snowflake. I'm like, no, they're not going to know what the fuck that is. Like, yeah. They're not going to know that's coke.
Everybody use pizzas. Yeah, you know, I got a couple pizzas. Y'all want some pizza? I've heard that. My uncles used to say that all the time. Like, they on to you now.
Yeah, straight up. And now they might even think you fucking kids and shit. They're like, damn, pizzas. Oh, they doing the pizza party shit. Like, oh, damn. That's that new mm-hmm. shit. Chicken nuggets and pizzas? I ain't no shit about it. And I'm like, oh, that's what they call fucking kids now? Shit. I know it's funny talking to my old. Whatever they're selling to me, I just follow their lead. You need to talk on this app? Fine, we'll talk on that app. Whatever you need to go to, fine, we'll fucking do mm-hmm. it. Like. whatever makes you feel better. As they fucking have everything in your whole goddamn system. Every fucking thing. Kanisha, it's always good chatting with you. It's always really good chatting with you. And I think it's either episode between 9 and 11 on the last season, season 11. In case you're digging through looking for that sex, the little sex.
Boop, yes, boop.
I thought it was a good idea too. Like, I don't understand what, like, me personally, hey, like, I'm down for talking, but not everybody wants to have a whole fucking conversation and negotiation about fucking. So, like, that little mm-hmm. beep, beep, like, I didn't think that was a bad idea at all.
It is perfect, especially for my broke vagina. That's my thing. I keep pissing on myself. Did I tell you that I was bringing groceries? I got to tell you this real quick. I was bringing groceries out of my car, yo. I have no control over my pee muscles, and I'm also scared I'm going to piss on my dude while we're doing it, too. I was pulling the groceries out and pissed. Luckily, I had a no panties and a fucking dress. Piss just started running everywhere, and I'm outside my apartment complex on a main ass street, and I just had to squat, and now I'm pissing on groceries. The piss wouldn't stop. People are driving by. I'm still waiting for my manager to knock on the door and be like, so why was you pissing in front of that apartment complex? I cannot believe this should happen to me. So that button would be perfect, because especially my vagina's broke, yo. I need the button. I'm pissing everywhere. Like, who wants to have sex and get pissed on? Well, a few people, actually.
Yeah, I was gonna say, you as you're telling this story, I know there's like 5 guys jerking off to it at least.
Oh shit, I need to get on OnlyFans and start pissing then.
Straight up, yeah, hell yeah, yo, you so awful. so bad. I was about to, you need to get on OnlyFans and start breastfeeding. Cash out.
Yo, listen, I have been sitting here contemplating OnlyFans. Like, yo, all my shows got canceled, everything. I'm like, yo, I got some old ass pictures of me when I was skinny. I'm about to post all these. I'm about to be doing everything. I can't breastfeed the baby, though. Somebody will report me for child pornography. I'd be like, what? This is mothering. And nobody wants to see motherhood.
Yeah, this is. I'm trying to teach people how to do mothering. Like, yeah, if you do it, like, it's a real, yeah. If you leave out masturbation and shit like that, and be like, hey, hi, this is Kanisha. I'm on OnlyFans, and I'm here to teach you how to teach your child how to masturbate. Or wait, no, don't do that. How to breastfeed.
I have that. What?
You're like, I don't, that's I don't want my kid fucking, I'm over here trying to lose your child for you.
I'm like, oh, the feds is listening. We're gonna talk about no pizzas, no shoes. Your ass going to jail.
Yeah, your ass fucking done. Yeah. Maybe OnlyFans. I don't even know if you can pee on OnlyFans. You probably can't.
I think you can do anything in the world on OnlyFans.
Shit, I was going to start my own fucking OnlyFans and just talk shit.
I'm going to just top lock in a bra. You should get on OnlyFans. You should get on OnlyFans. Do tutorials.
Yeah, teach people how to fucking, do sex tutorials. OnlyFans, sex tutorials. I got a homegirl whose dad was like a fucking con man. And he was getting he was getting fucking 10 racks per class. And there would be YouTube classes all over the fucking country. So it'd be him with like 1, 2, 3, like 9 boxes. So this guy's sitting there, he just made $90,000. And she's showing me this shit. And like, I used to fuck old girls, the homie. And she would be showing me this shit. He was like, yeah, you have to, like, shut your eyes and breathe through your dick. Like, he was just saying the wildest shit, like, bro, you breathe through your dick, son? Like, he was telling motherfuckers to breathe through their dicks 90 racks a time. Like,
I'm about to get on, yo.
It's a market out there. He did it through the fucking hippie market. Like, we walked up in that bitch looking like all linen with the cape on, you know what I mean? Like with them drapey capes on and a fucking staff with a crystal on it telling you how to fuck better.
Oh my God, are you serious?
Yep. Yeah,
I think my mom watched him.
Might have. Maybe she watched the rerun. I watched him make 90 grand telling motherfuckers how to breathe through their dick. I'm like, what the fuck job am I doing, man?
Man, I need to get a job. Breathe through your vagina in, push the air out.
Yep.
That would allow you to grip it better. You would definitely get a wedding ring. Saying anything. now I'm about to. You think I'm playing?
You on some more holistic hood shit. You like that? You'll definitely get a some red bottoms and a wedding ring off this motherfucker.
You want that new bag, bitch? Listen. Do you want him to buy your son a bike? Breathe your vagina.
There's an eye in the back of your vagina. Look at it as it's look at the head of the penis as it watch it focus on it with your vagina eye. Get that bike. Mm-hmm. You fucking love it.
Mr. Chow's, it is. Breathe your vagina. We get the whole type of shit. You want to piss off your baby dad? Go breathe through your vagina with his best friend. Breathe. Be doing stupid shit on there. Good red shit. Oh my God, I love it. It's my new business.
Yes, me too. All right. Well, you be well and have a great fucking day. Yeah.
I am. I'm teaching sign language, so I got to go teach some classes online.
Yeah. Oh yeah, I forgot you knew sign language. The woman of many different fucking things.
You can follow me at Kanisha Is Comedy or my mom's page, MOM_ish_. And sign language classes are $20 for 30-minute sessions. And they're all individualized classes over Zoom. So come on over my place virtually. Yeah, I got three students so far. So come on
teach you how to, she teach you how to do sign language with your pussy when you're talking to a man.
Oh, I could definitely do that.
See, look at that. All right, we already got your in. We already got your in. All right, Kanisha. Be well.
All right. Thanks for having me. Miss you guys. See you soon.
See you soon. All right, that was Kanisha Bus. Right. And we are we're gonna play some music. Come on back. Got the news with John.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
Ladies and gentlemen, fighting out of the blue corner, raised in the Garden State, the corniest man in hip hop, John the Chin Matthews. Tonight in the red corner, hailing from pop culture known to anyone paying attention, it's the mighty Slang. Welcome to Slang versus John.
Slang versus John. John being the fucking cornball of the station. We throw some slang words at him and see if he can get it. You want to go old school or new school?
Old school. Old school. I'm feeling very confident about this. I've had a couple of good ones.
All right. Oh, man. Punani.
Punani. I mean, that's something that's in popular culture. So, punani, I'm just going to have to call it. That is vagina. That is pussy.
Yeah, I didn't write this shit. They did.
Punani. All right.
Okay, let's try it. All right. Two for two, or one for one. Let's see if you can keep it going.
Mm-hmm.
Lampin'.
Lampin'?
Lampin'.
I mean, is that from, like, Arkansas or something? Lampin'? I mean, what is this? A lampin'. All right, so when I'm out looking for my hookers, I'm assuming they're down in the red light district, and there are lots of lamps down there, so I'm going to go down there. I'm going to go lampin' and get some hookers. That's what we're doing. You can come if you want to, but I'm going lampin' tonight.
Oh, John. Hit him with the...
Nobody uses this.
It's from the 90s. It's like chilling.
What?
Yeah, it's just chilling, like hanging out. You lamping.
What's the origin of that? Lamping.
I don't know. Like a lamp, I guess. I don't know.
Yeah.
That was one that I didn't use that much, but I was familiar with. Yeah.
I've never
heard. You over here lamping, you know.
Lamping.
Chilling, hanging out. All right. Let's see if you can redeem yourself.
Oh, yeah. All right. Fine.
Old school. Bammer.
A bammer. All right. So a bammer, that is going to be possibly a person who is probably having lots of anal sex, maybe, or I don't know. I mean, there's a lot of, you know, you're bamming, and so, you know, I've heard that Sally's really a bammer, so she's out there. I don't know. I've never heard this.
So like a bammer, someone that has a lot of anal sex.
Because you're bamming them.
I'm
bringing
that
back.
But you said Sally's a bammer. Is the bammer the one that's doing the fucking or getting fucked?
Sally is the one receiving.
So if you're
maybe then Steve's the bammer. I don't know.
So redo the sentence so I can understand it.
All right. So Steve is really a bammer. So Sally, be careful. He's going for your ass. I don't know, man. I don't know. I've never heard this in my life.
Bammer's like shitty, like whack. Like fucking poor quality. And it could be like bammer weed, or a person could be a bammer.
Oh.
Like this. Nice. Yeah.
Nope. No. Never.
Never heard that one, huh?
Not. That wasn't happening in Montclair, New Jersey.
Nope. Not bad, though.
Not bad. Slang versus John. We gone.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
All right, y'all. You want to be part of the show? You want to be able to call in? Like tomorrow we're doing What Would You Do? You got a problem? Call up. Well, you can't call the station because the station doesn't work for us. But we found a workaround. It's 213-205-3747. 213-205-3747. Text anything. If you want mixes or pill mixes, type in pill mix, and I'll send you the pill mix from last week as well. Boom. There it is. Follow at All Out Show, and that's on everything, and at One More Jude, and you can go to onemorejude.com. And if you really want to tweet me, which I don't always get them for some reason, you can go to @rude_jude. Tweet me a couple times, and hopefully I get it. All right, y'all, let's go.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you. And now, it's time for News from the Chin with John Z. Matthews.
Women's Health Magazine, they're putting together this helpful list here, or suggestions, things to do if you're feeling sexually frustrated in your relationship.
Call me up. Like... Right now, or for like during the Wuhan shit? Is it just in general?
Yeah, I think they're going for sort of a broad
sense here. What do you do like right now? Like I don't. Call up couples. I would love to know. All right, what do you do when you're in a bad relationship? Not a bad relationship. You're probably in a good relationship, but you're just. The sex has just turned to shit. And now you're with each other every fucking day. With time.
First of all, yeah.
What do you do?
Don't blame your partner. That's going to lead you into a death spiral, but I don't know how you couldn't. But instead of blaming, discuss things.
Yeah, sometimes you're just not in the mood or some shit. Sometimes you got to get your timing right. I was watching Shark Tank. Is this Damon coming on?
I'm still, yeah, he's working through some things.
All right, but. Yeah. So Damon should be coming on. But they had this thing in there where you got to fucking, there's these two buttons. And if you're kind of in the mood, you hit the button. And if the other person doesn't hit the button, then it's not that big of a deal. And they really shit on it, and... I got to tell you, like, I'm all for conversation and stuff like that, but I kind of understand where they're coming from. Like, yo, I would be like, you down for a quickie button. You know what I mean? Like, if you're just down for a quickie, you just, doot. Because sometimes it's a fucking ordeal. You know what I mean? Like.
So, but you're being serious. You would have the little device by your bed. So then the lady presses the button. Then you see, oh, she wants to do it, and then you accept or you decline, and then everything's fine.
No. You don't see if she wants to do it. The thing is she hits the button, and if you're like, if she's kind of in the mood, she hits the button, and you're not in the mood, nothing happens.
Oh.
She doesn't get to feel rejected. You know what I mean? She just is like, yeah. Then if you really want some pussy, like, you be on that shit. You be really rubbing on her. If she really wants some dick, she'll be like, she'll curl up on top of you and do the old leg rub on you and stuff like that, like a kitten. Like, that's another thing. This is that midway point that you might be able to get. Let's say you get 30% more sex out of it because you guys are both using it. I don't think it's the worst idea. You know, if you're both, you know, not that great at communicating.
Well, so, but for you, since you've got these,
I would be like, let's say I've been with a girl for a long time. I'd be like, little babe, right. I would love to fuck you. I got 10 minutes in me.
10 minutes.
Yeah.
All right. But when you've been...
What's wrong? Why are you laughing at that?
Oh, I don't know. I mean, to me, that sounds normal. But if you were just to say, okay, I've got 10 minutes, okay, it just seems so clinical. But
that's why the little doot-doot is clinical as well. But it's not like, yo, man, like... Because that's a reality of shit. It's like, look, man, I got a long ass day tomorrow. I just fucking had a long ass day today. I'm beat. I love you. I'd love to spend some time with you. Like, this is how much energy I got to fucking put towards it. And there's two things that would suck. One, getting rejected if you try to put the moves on the girl because she's too fucking tired herself. And two, like, you put in your fuck, you go hard for like 10 minutes and then she's like, is that it? You like, damn, like, fuck. That's all. Yeah, that's all I got. I'm dead. I'm fucking dead to the world over here. So that's kind of, I don't know. I agree. I think that communication's number one. Not everybody's that good at communication and we're getting worse as we go. Does that make communication even worse? Possibly, yes. But if we gotten this far, what are you gonna do? Fucking sacrifice your relationship to prove a point, you know?
So, but for you, when was the last time that you put the moves on some lady and she just said, no, I'm not in the mood, I can't do it? I mean, that must have been ages ago.
Yeah, and then it makes me even want to fuck her even more. Cause then she's like, "Nah, I don't want to." And I'm like, "What? Nah, you finna want to? Let me just do this and do that, do this and then do that, and do this. Stop it, dude. Okay, I'm chill. And then you just do this and do that, and then all of a sudden they're kind of wanting to." And then the next thing you know, you blam, 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 blam. That's when they really don't. That's when you blam, 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 blam. And like, God. And then you don't go too hard for too long, and then you just be like, oh, and there we go. Kiss them, go to bed. Sweet dreams. Glad you don't want to.
That's also on the list. If you're feeling frustrated, go to sleep. Make sleep a priority, because I guess the stress is also killing you. That's also on the list. So
that's not on. That's what I just said wasn't on the list. What I said was like you kind of keep going for it, and then you fuck them to sleep.
Oh.
You don't make them do a marathon, but you fuck them hard and you fuck them to bed, and then you be like, all right, baby, I love you. Here, go to bed. You need anything? Nah, you good. All right, I got you. I do a lot of shit wrong, like. You know, my exes will sit down and have a 40-page thing of all the shit I do wrong, but there's certain shit I do right. You know what I mean? And it was pretty fair to say if me and you are together for a while, me and the girl, I'll get your number. I'll get that shit. I'll have your fucking number. And then I'll have your number.
There was one lady I was dating for a while. I mean, I think she would probably be considered sexually frustrated with me. But she, you know, by the way, I like having sex. All right, just let me laugh.
I'm listening, bro. Of course she would be. All right, I can't believe she would be sexually frustrated with you. Keep going.
She nice. We still talk now and again. She's cool. But she had this farmland up north in Humboldt, and she wanted to just fuck every day, like all over the farm. And she told me that pretty early on. She said, hey, just so you know, we're going to have to do this all the time. And I remember just looking at the sun like, ugh, boy, this is going to be kind of rough. But, I mean, no, again, fucking's great. But, I mean, like every day, like over
in
the barn.
How did you tell her no?
What, I mean, how could I say no? And that's what she.
No, you should have been like, yo, that I ain't that guy for you, baby.
It would have saved us some time, I think.
That yeah. Cause I remember I had an ex that all she wanted, like, no matter how much I fucked her, it wasn't enough. If I fucked her 3 days a week, she wanted 4 days. If I fucked her 4 days, she wanted 5 days. And this ain't like a little 3 minutes here, this fuck. Like, this is like sessions. And if she wanted like fucking 6 days, we're doing 6 day sessions going in on the weekends. You know, like, it was no matter what, it was never enough. And it just felt like a job after a while.
Right.
It literally felt like unsatisfying. Felt like I was bad at life, because no matter what I threw at her, like, no matter what I threw at her pussy, it was never enough. It was like, woof, give me more. Woof, give me more. I get out the way of that shit. Some people like to fuck and fuck, and like, that's all they do. But like, yo, I got other shit I need to do, sweets.
Yeah, I know. All right,
and the worst part is, they'll get some fucking loser, and it's not, I'm not calling, like, not everybody's like that, but like, you only got so much time. So if you are fucking, if you're fucking every single day, all the fucking time, what else are you putting your time into? Do you have an infinite amount of energy? Do you got like tons of energy to do that and to fucking succeed in life? If you do, you're a badass. You probably work out all the time. You're the shit. If you don't fall into that category, you're just the guy that's fucking all the time for somewhere to live.
And at the end of the list here, see a couple's therapist, something I've never done, but I almost did with that lady, but that has never happened. Have you ever done that? Gone to a therapist to deal with a relationship? Probably not.
Yeah, I went to a therapist to do. I tried a couple of couples therapy.
Well,
did it work? It didn't work. We broke up.
Yeah.
And then she was like, I told you. She didn't say it like that, but she was like, see, this is what I was pointing out for. And then I was like, yep, she did that. And this is what I was pointing out to. Yep, you're right. And then this is what I was pointing out to. Like, thanks, therapist. It was almost, she had to be like, I told you so, bitch. I was like, And then she was like, it's going to cost more. And I was like, all right, man, I'm not coming with you no more. I'm done. Done. So they're telling you to go to couples therapy?
Yeah. But I think, well, I mean, hey, it could work. But if I've reached that point, I would have to think the end is near. But maybe that's a loser's attitude. You got to keep pushing, I guess. Who knows?
Yeah, it's a long life. Like, hopefully you want to avoid couples therapy. A lot of times it's like, yo, if it's gotten this far, it might be too late. But
yeah.
Yo, especially the worst is when you meet a motherfucker and they're talking about couples therapy like 4 months into it, and you're like, whoa, dog, like, this is for like deep rooted like resentment of you not showing up to their graduation 4 years ago. You know what I mean? Or You hating their family or something, or their family hates you. It can't be this shit this early, man. You gotta talk. Talking, man, talking. Number one, communicate. Gotta communicate. That's say it better than that. Communicate. What?
We got another study here talking about psychedelic mushrooms.
Hey,
treat your depression. And I mean, it seems like every month there's another study out from a reputable source talking about more scientists looking at this as the way of treating depression rather than antidepressants. Because, of course,
you know why they're doing that? Because fucking pharmaceuticals are dumping money into research.
You think that's driving?
That's why. Yeah. Fuck yeah.
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 Is it a bad thing?
I'm just telling you what it is. Like, this has been around since forever. Now, finally, pharmaceuticals are like, maybe we can make our money off of this shit. Let's look into it. Like, it's going this way anyway. We need to get in, so we need to start running tests and all this shit. And it's like stuff that people have done this stuff forever. No. It's like, yeah, dog. Yeah, you feeling fucked up about a loss of a family member, man. You do some mushrooms and it helps clear that shit out. Who the fuck knows?
About everything. I mean, even if you are suddenly dealing with cancer, you take your mushrooms, and then it sort of changes your perspective, calms you down.
Helps you deal with death. Yeah, your whole relationship with death, all of that shit. Yeah.
The other day when you and I were talking about it, some listeners hit me up and said, hey, I'll send you some mushrooms. I don't know if I should do that, but maybe I will.
I'd take it. Mm. I don't know what you're worried about. You ain't got no narcissism. They're all cool, man.
Yeah. I'll get it in the mail.
Check out their Instagram. Yeah, be like, show me your IG. And then I wouldn't say it like that, but you'd be like, what's your IG? And then give them a look. And it you could pretty much tell, unless this guy's been deep cover for like 7 years and he wants to blow his whole cover just to fucking his 7 years of being in depth in the mushrooms field to like get you for a fucking ounce. I don't think it's gonna be like that, bro. I'm just saying.
I'm not that paranoid at this point. No. But well, I kind of am. But really, it looks as though, as you pointed out, that if you're taking the antidepressants, you know, when you're taking those, that sort of can alleviate some of the stress you're feeling for a little bit. But once you stop taking those pills, bang, it's over. But with the mushrooms, it kind of like changes your whole makeup, and that lasts. That those benefits last beyond, you know, that.
You get that glow, bro. You get the after mushrooms glow.
Yeah.
I'm for it.
Do you ever get paranoid?
What's that?
Do you ever get paranoid?
Yeah.
Or like get caught up in like bad memories and shit like that?
Yeah. There was some other shit that happened where like I was on shrooms and I blacked out. I didn't even realize this shit. I was on acid and blacked out. And I was very upset about something. And old girl was like, there was just no talking to you, so I just went in the other room until you chilled out. It's like, thank you. She's like, do you know what you're mad about? I was like, no, I don't. And that was very scary for me. I was like, fuck. Because you'd like to think that you got your shit together, but you don't. But, like, you're not a violent person. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not a violent dude. I guess I was walking around with a knife, too. Yeah, yelling about shit. Butt-ass naked. But it all made sense to me because I had grabbed a knife to grab some citrus fruit, slice it up, because citrus fruit is delicious on psychedelics. But I guess I forgot about it and just started yelling about shit.
Plans changed, but something tells me you're taking a heavier dose than I will. I'm not really going for it on the level you did that.
Yeah, time. And it's like, look, you got shit that you're pissed off about, and as do I, and it's job related. So, like, it was just like, I was just fucking, you know. We're in the middle of some goddamn fucking government forced quarantine, and I'm pissed off about my job, so like I might
feel better
freak
after
out
the trip
for a minute. Yeah, I do. I really wish I would have known. I wish I would have been a bit more present so that I could have really worked through things, but I guess sometimes, you know, you can work through things and not be all the way there. But it was like hours later, she had to explain to me what happened. I was like, word? She was like, yeah. Like, fuck. And she was like, it was a knife that was kind of scaring me. I was like,
yeah. I think I would have been a little freaked out if you were walking around naked next to me with a knife.
With a knife? Well, I'm running up. I wasn't like putting it in her face. I was just walking around looking for. I was freaking. I was yelling. I was freaking out, yelling at the air, looking for oranges. What are you gonna do? What are you gonna do? And the funny thing was, is like, all right, man. Before we do this shit, let's not get too crazy, because sometimes we'll get like real dark and go into fucked up places and have crazy sex. And the whole part, I was like, let's keep it light, dude. Let's keep it light. Meanwhile, I'm butt naked with a knife. stalking the fucking living room for fucking oranges. You live, you learn. What are you gonna do?
It's all about degrees. So, I don't know what you're doing for coffee these days, but I, for one, am thankful we're not drinking the office coffee right now. And it turns out that scientists have determined the healthiest way to make coffee. Can you guess what that would
be? What is it?
It was your filter.
I don't know, French press? Oh, where you run it through the...
Yeah, a filtered brew is the way to go. Because
like a filtered brew is like at the hotel or some shit?
Oh, I mean, they're just saying filtered coffee, so I would think that it has to do with literally a filter, those paper filters that you run the coffee
through. Like they have it the cheap coffee, like the cheap motels.
Yeah, okay, exactly. And that's because you are filtering out these chemicals that lead to a higher level of cholesterol, and that's knocking you out. But really, the filtered coffee drinkers, they had a 15% lower risk of death from any cause when compared to drinking no coffee. So you're actually helping yourself.
Hey.
Yeah.
I'll get one of those filled. I got the French press.
Tastes good, though.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. I'm to the point where I'm just past taste. I don't even give a fuck. It's just like, give me my drugs. Give me my drugs so I can finish this fucking show. Give me.
So the French press, though, that's kind of like mainlining it. How many of those do you drink? How many pots of that or cups?
I only make one. Maybe I'll drink one or two at the most. Yeah, one or two at the most. I'm trying to think of, like, if I drink too much coffee, do I stay up too late? But I don't know if there's a direct correlation between the shit. Like, I've had one cup and just been wired and up to, like, fucking 3 a.m, just like, how come you're not asleep yet? So I think it has to also just do with the amount of stress that I'm going through. So maybe if I drink more coffee during the day, it'll actually like make it easier for me to run through things during the day and have less stress. I'm gonna try it that way. I know it sounds like it shouldn't work, but maybe I'll give it a try. Maybe I'll drink more coffee.
Well, they're saying here, overall, those that drink up to 4 cups of coffee a day, they were found to have the lowest rate of death. So that's your sweet spot. I guess
I need to really step my shit up, bro.
Start pounding.
I'm at like, I usually do one. At the most, it'll be 3. And the ones that we have at the office, I don't even know how to count those. Ugh. I get a triple shot espresso, which a triple double shot. So that's 6 cups of coffee. And it's like drinking just mud water. And then maybe you might have a little whoop, little buzz. That's it. Huh. So all right, man. I'm gonna drink another cup of coffee. Go start going. I'm listening. Get your shit going. Well, I'm not listening. Just wait a second. Hold on 1 second.
Uh-huh. I had to go get a refill.
Thank you.
Not a problem.
To many of my fans, by the way, that sent me coffee because I was bitching about the coffee. A lot of Cafe Bustelo.
What the hell is that?
It's Latino shit. It's Latin shit. I know for sure it's popular on the fucking on the East Coast, like Puerto Ricans, Cubans, shit like that. I like that shit a lot.
Taking care of you.
And then there's another one. There's like, it's like ex-vets and shit like that uses. It's like bulletproof or something. That shit fucking wires you, but the fucking amount of heartburn in it is just crazy. And then what I found was the best for me, that was the most chillest, it was the kahuna shit. Kahuna, kuna, whatever it is. The Hawaiian shit, whatever they sell in Hawaii. Least amount of heartburn,
most of like from heartburn to fucking the heartburn to caffeine ratio. Great. Love it. I'm going to order some more of that on fucking on Amazon.
All right. We're going to head back into relationships for a second here.
Hey, that's what I'm here
for whatever reason, I've got a bunch of steps here to help you conquer your fear of commitment. And I guess if someone had asked me if you have a fear of commitment, I probably have to say yes to that, but I don't know if that's true or not. Do you think that you have a fear of commitment?
I got way more of a fear of commitment than you do. You live with women and shit like that. Like, I will fucking bail. I've never lived with a woman. So I'm 42.
That's amazing. That is amazing.
Isn't that crazy? I'd be like, what? If I was a woman, I'd be like, what? This motherfucker's never lived with a woman since, and he's 42?
Wow.
Yikes. I know. Granted, all right, so what are some of the shit? What up?
I've hit some landmines in my adventures, but all right, let's see here. So to get over your fear of commitment, take responsibility for your relationship anxiety, which sounds like you may have done that, but I guess
I'm working on it. More so than I did before. Before I just be like, she does this, she does that. You know, it's never my fault that I'm a fucking maniac. It's her fault that she's doing human things. She's behaving like a human and not being perfect. Fucking could bitch. What are you thinking? Not being perfect.
Your fear of being with the so-called wrong person.
I know. And the thing is, there is no right person. Nobody's perfect. You have to accept people for who they are and like look for the qualities that really matter to you.
I think that leads us over here to have a realistic expectation.
Yeah.
To earth.
I don't know. Like for some people, it doesn't matter. For me, it's like, I just want to be able to trust you, have good sex, and have good conversation. That's pretty. Those are like the three main things. Trust, sex, combo, and both have like the same views on where we're trying to get to.
So, but you'd put sex before conversation? I mean, you got to hang out a lot more than you're having sex.
I mean, it's all like those are all things that if we don't have good sex, yeah, if we don't have good conversation and I don't trust you, it's done. Those are like the Holy Trinity.
Yeah.
I think we can't even move on to the other shit. That's just the base, the little fucking base core for Judy. Sex, convo, and fucking trust. All right, what else?
Trust. All right.
What else?
Understand where your fear of commitment comes from, and that I have no clue with you. There's got to be some sort of trauma or something happened back.
You don't have any fear of commitment with me? Well, John, my mom would drive me around as a four-year-old and fucking cheat on my dad while I was there and have me in the car and all that shit. And then would have to go home, and if I wasn't told ahead of time to lie to him and he would like finesse answers out of me, there would be a huge fucking fight that often ended in violence, and the police would come. And that would happen to me on a regular basis. So that was one of the things that didn't help me with trusting women.
I think that certainly qualifies.
Yeah.
And yeah. Now, let's see. Well, this leads us back to the earlier stuff. Don't assume that your relationship or partner will meet all of your needs. All right, fine. Yeah.
Yo, hey, if they do, you're a lucky motherfucker. God bless you. And really be grateful for what you two have. Like, don't take that for granted, because so many people do not have that.
Right.
All right. Keep going.
And finally, don't be defensive. Address each other's imperfections without trying to fix them. So I guess it's basically what you said early on. Just try to deal with the person and realize that they're human. That seems to be the overall thrust of this.
Yeah, that's it. And there's certain shit that, like, I got a homie whose man is there for her for everything, but he just shows up late for things, which to me is the ultimate disrespect. And she's just learning to cope with it because he's there on so many other, he like bang, bang, bang. He checks off so many other things. But to me, that's like, you late? You have no respect for me nor my time. Who the fuck do you think you are? Just tell him the wrong time. That's what I said. Just tell that motherfucker the wrong time. If it's 5:30, tell him 5. If he gets there at 5, be like, I got a couple things to do and we'll be there. If he complains too much, be like, look, I got to keep telling you the wrong times to keep you guessing, to make sure that you're on time, because you're not good at being on time. They tend not to like that, but like, that's the realness. You hit them with that real. That motherfucking real, son. Real. What else?
And quickly, well, I mean, there's this show that I don't think you're watching, but it's on ESPN. It's The Last Dance, and it focuses on the Bulls.
Michael George's last season, right?
Yeah, you got to watch. I've watched all four. It's fucking amazing. I love it, man.
I don't have the everybody I've spoken to loves the fucking show. Like, they all really are into it. I got to check and see if whatever Hulu package I have is covered. And are you getting knocked? Is your streaming fucked, or is it just me?
Not really. I mean, again, I've got some weird back channel things going on. It seems bypass.
I should have asked like a regular person if their streaming's fucked. You're probably connected to NASA or some shit. You and NASA got the same fucking goddamn internet.
Got a couple of levels going on, but over the weekend, so ESPN, they bled out two more, and it looked at the sort of Dennis Rodman experience, and Carmen Electra, that lady Carmen Electra, she makes an appearance, because I'd forgotten, but they were married at some point. Man, she is smoking hot. I'd forgotten all about that lady. But she was someone from like my youth where I was like, oh, look at how beautiful she is. She is fucking, even to this day, she's gorgeous, man. Carmen Electra.
I interviewed her.
Oh, that's right. I remember that.
Yeah.
In archives. That's right. Yeah.
Yeah. You guys didn't archive it, but it's there.
It's there. I know where it is.
It's there. I can find it. It's there. I got my own way of archiving. You say that something, and then I have to go dig up and find it. But if you don't say anything, then I can't find it. There's no list. It's not just you, man. You're not the head. You're not the head. This doesn't lay on you. You're not responsible for this shit anymore. You're responsible for enough. So there you go.
Carmen Electra. They had sex over at the at their practice court. Well, she goes through a whole list of shit. But
she fucked up. She fucked Jordan too. Oh, Jordan.
Oh no. Maybe I don't know. Just Dennis.
Oh, she was fucking Rodman at the practice court.
Yeah, at the practice facility where they nonstop. Well, at any rate, yeah, they were doing lots of fucking.
You know, one of the Jenny Jones guy that I used to work with was a cameraman, and the cameraman there, they were either young and super green or fucking the oldest, grimiest pieces of shit that you'd ever deal with. And I always like dealing with old, grimy pieces of shit because they knew they could deal with things, you know what I mean? And he was telling me that he was running around filming Dennis Rodman shit, and Dennis went so hard that he broke his dick. He just broke that bitch.
Oh yeah, I remember that story.
Broke it in half. Like, that was not a, that was like a real thing. He went so hard with the chicks that he broke his dick.
Chicks and more, I think. But yes, he's having lots of sex.
That's amazing. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, I'm sure he's, I'm sure he's fucking some dudes in there. I saw that. I got to see the fucking the 30 for 30 on Dennis. Shout out to Doug. He was one of the producers on that shit. Yeah. Shit was fucking nuts.
Well, outside of that, I do some good news for you.
All right, what's that?
And now, time for good news.
People are still adopting kids, even during all this. Wouldn't really cross my mind, but this is over in Arkansas. This lady here, Kimberly Wanecki, she and her husband, they've been fostering parents for a bit, and now they've just adopted another one, Jaden, and they did it over Zoom. So they're just picking kids off.
Damn, son. They got a kid off of Zoom?
Well, because people aren't going to court these days, so they have to find a way around that. So like, we'll take that one. I'm being crude. I'm sure they looked into it, but yeah, they're cute little kid, little Jaden.
You're being crude. I'm being crude. That was lightweight crude. Fucking whatever. That's dope. That's cool. The kids are getting adopted, man. Kids need to be adopted. It's dope that that's what I'm like. Anybody wants an adopted kid, I don't care if they're fucking gay or fucking straight or whatever the fuck, you know. Even if they believe stupid fucking things, like, still helpful for the child and helps them, like, just deal and survive. So hats off to all of those people out there that actually, all the foster parents that actually, you know, take time out, get to know the kids and adopt them and help raise them to be better kids. And it goes one of two routes. It goes, they completely fucking claim you and you're everywhere and that's my mom and I love you and all that shit. Or it can be like, they never raised me at all. But whatever. You got to enjoy their time together.
And don't let coronavirus stop you. If you want to adopt, get on the Zoom. You could rescue some kid.
Go help a kid. There it is. Let's go.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
All right, that was the show. I would love to thank John. But fuck him. You don't get no thanks. Mm. Eat a dick, John. Eat a fucking dick. Just kidding. Thanks, John. Thanks goes out to fucking... yo, you know whose birthday it is? I think it's Chris. Is it Chris's birthday today?
It is Chris's birthday.
Happy birthday to Chris. Happy birthday to you, bud. Even though you're not on the show right now because of fucking Wuhan bullshit, we still appreciate you and can't wait to get back to all of us working together. Shout out to Keenan and thanks to Dan. My name is Jude Angelini. We're out of here. Let's go.